I really liked math and I really liked biology. I was really passionate about helping people. So I wanted to do engineering that would kind of incorporate all of those.
She came to Purdue to study with me, and my field is microfluidics. That's basically the motion of small amounts of fluid.
What we do is we hold the fluid still, and we put particles in that fluid, and they exhibit a random motion, and we calculate that random motion, or Brownian motion, using image processing algorithms. And so based on the movement of those particles, we can find out things like particle size or solution viscosity. So the question was, okay, how do we take this out of the lab? How do we make this something real? Can we measure the viscosity of solutions with DNA in it? Will that make a difference for an application? Will somebody care about that?
We've taken those DNA measurements and moved it into pathogen detection, so measuring the presence of pathogen DNA.
And there was this aha moment when the chemistry finally worked, and you know, our experiments agreed with our simulations.
Dr. Jacqueline Linnes here in BME had collaborations with the Emerging Pathogens Institute in Haiti for cholera detection.
Cholera is really appealing as a first pathogen in this project because it's in water, which means that we don't have to deal with human samples. It's also a low concentration that most measurement methods aren't able to detect in a portable field method. Right now, if a water source is infected with cholera, you go to the source and then you bring it back to the lab, and 3 days later you find out if there was cholera. In the meantime, people have been drinking it. Those people that have been drinking the water that had cholera contamination could then get infected and have the disease cholera, and then you would detect that when they've gone to the hospital and have gotten particularly sick. In contrast, if you use PathVis, you can detect within 30 minutes from any sample of water.
PathVis is, you know, the result of 5 years of work.
Katie and I independently came up with the idea of taking the measurements that she was doing on the microscope and putting it on a smartphone.
The device in and of itself is like your portable laboratory. It has lenses to act as your microscope, and it has electronic components to do heating, for example, to allow for DNA amplification to occur on that chip that has your environmental water sample. It has an app on it, which has all the algorithms embedded already to image these particles moving, and then from that movement, extract out those values to determine if a pathogen is present or not. Within that app, we have a geotagging interface. So after you've done the detection, it actually tags where that detection was done and it timestamps it. So then in real time, you can start to see where are different detections of diseases occurring. And so you can go to that spot and remediate the area or help the patient. After we saw that these smartphone algorithms were working, it really made us more confident and more excited because we thought, wow, this could be something real. A lot of us were really excited about entrepreneurship. And so here at Purdue, we have the Burton Morgan business plan competition, and it was the first one that we did. And we saw people were really excited. And so of course, that made us want to do more competitions.
We submitted to the Vodafone Wireless Innovation Project. Jackie Linnes and I flew out to San Francisco, gave the presentation and pitched our ideas to the Vodafone panel of judges, and were thrilled to then learn shortly thereafter that we won first place. It's $100,000 per year for 3 years, furthering the wireless technology and the smartphone platform.
We're hoping to detect not only cholera, but also diagnose human diseases like malaria, like HIV.
And also enabling us to go to Haiti to field test.
Start looking at the users behind it and really talk to the people, because once again, I get to see something that I was doing in the lab go out of the lab, and there's nothing more exciting than that. So definitely for PathVis, that's just so exciting to see. Getting to help lives with it, there is nothing cooler than that to me, and getting to do it with science is even better because it's the mixture of two things I really love.